Hey guys, Legendary Ghidorah here, bringing you another remastered video because I got time on my hands for you guys. And well, yeah, I'm gonna be starting a job soon. So, you know, I filled out an application. I got this job at Wegmans. So, yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And, yeah, let's begin. Grimlock is one of the most powerful beings in all of comics, and yes, this is a remastered edition, as I will be doing for pretty much all of my power scaling videos, including characters like Groudon and Kyogre. So yeah, hope you guys enjoy this little video. Grimlock is actually one of the strongest beings in the Transformers universe, and actually is the Transformers, pretty much account for the Hulk. I would actually say he's the Transformers version of Red Hulk because he's more militaristic and more crafty. But like the Hulk, the angrier he gets, the stronger he gets. So you kind of have that. Then you have... Well, sorry, let's dive into feats. Duh. Grimlock is strong enough to grapple and overpower Titan-level Decepticons like Trypticon. He's actually ripped Trypticon's arm off, ripped like chunks out of it, and managed to stagger Trypticon with his punches. Trypticon is a character that could at least... And I'd say at least wipe a planet surface clean. So already Grimlock, it was a planetary threat. Then you have characters like Thunderwing and the Fallen and Unicron. So let's get into those, right? But first, he's been able to overpower Predacons. Predacons are capable of going toe-to-toe with prime-level characters. Prime-level characters like Ultra Magnus, Megatron... And Tarn, Onslaught, characters that can give Optimus Prime and Megatron a run for their money. Scorponok as well. He's beaten the crap out of Scorponok and has beaten the mess out of Tarn. Prime level characters are capable of destroying stars and solar systems with their attacks. So you have those characters. Grimlock is now showing that he could wipe out a star and a solar system with relative ease. Then now let's get into the good stuff. Thunderwing. Thunderwing is the right hand of Unicron in some origins. Sometimes he's just a normal Decepticon, and sometimes he's just a Titan level, you know, Decepticon. Thunderwing, in the version that Grimlock was fighting as well, he made Thunderwing buckle over with a blow to the gut. And Thunderwing was taking attacks from Optimus Prime, so Grimlock, yes, is stronger than characters like Optimus Prime and Megatron. He has been able to even ragdoll Megatron on some occasions, like it's sometimes ridiculous. He's just able to straight up come up and bully Megatron. It's really funny when you guys watch it, even in the G1 cartoons, like Megatron, this guy that, you know, slaps other Autobots around. Even is able to beat up Optimus Prime on a couple of occasions. Next thing you know, Grimlock comes in. Excuse me, Optimus Prime. Are you struggling with him? Please. Help. I got you, Prime. I got you. Beating up Scorponok and Tarn are, you know, not small feats either. Because, you know, they've been able to give Optimus Prime. And Tarn was actually able to, Tarn was able to give an antimatter amped Megatron a run for his money. So, yeah. Megatron is also a very powerful character, even being able to overpower and one-shot the likes of Dr. Doom in an Avengers and Transformers crossover. And even, you know, he was able to one-shot Dr. Doom, Spider-Man, and Luke Cage, which are relatively high-level characters. So, you kind of have to consider that as well. With Grimlock's durability in mind, he's also been able to be in the presence of Unicron and take a blast from True Form Primus, who would be multiversal beings and even multiversal singularities. Being in the presence of Unicron, it makes Grimlock durable down to the molecular level because, well, Unicron has been able to erase entire galaxies and rip apart space and time with his presence alone. So Grimlock has some molecular level durability. Grimlock as well has been able to take Shockwave's cannon. That is not a small feat, as Onyx Prime, who was a black hole manipulator, as well as a Prime, who is a multiversal singularity as well, and who was able to, and who is the first Beast Transformer as well, that making him probably the strongest, if not one of the strongest members of the Primes, was killed by one blast by this cannon, and Onyx Prime, and Grimlock was able to take this blast and recover with relatively no damage, even taking a blast at point blank and still surviving it, which means Shockwave couldn't get the job done. And that kind of means, you know, that Grimlock has higher durability than the first Beast Transformer, which means he's probably stronger. I'd probably say he's stronger and more durable than Onyx Prime at this point. In terms of speed, Grimlock is not as fast. I think he would probably be able to reach up to at least maybe a standard, maybe like 100, maybe 150 miles per hour in his T-Rex form. Maybe with his jet boosters, he's actually probably able to hit at least Mach 2, maybe. I would give him Mach 2 or Mach 3, considering they are jet boosters. And if we count the fastest jet, or at least, you know, an average jet, they'd be able to hit Mach 5. So he'd probably be Mach 5 in travel speed. Now, in combat speed, I would say Grimlock is definitely immeasurable in terms of speed. He's blocked Shockwave's Dark Matter cannon. Dark Matter is actually considered to be beyond light speed capabilities. And, you know, it's just it's just very, so, honestly, it's just, it is what it is. So that makes Grimlock's reflexes actually beyond the speed of light, and he's been able to block multiple energy blasts before. Energy blasts by even our science would be at least light year speed, you know, 10,000 light years. So you would actually have to be relatively faster than light to even block a simple energy blast. In terms of hacks, Grimlock is, you know, he's a Hulk. You know, he's a Hulk, he's a Hulk iteration. A Hulk, what's the word for it? Incarnation. The Transformers version of the Hulk, okay? The matter he gets, the stronger he gets, okay? And that's pretty much one of his hacks. And it's allowed him to even get the surprise and jump on Shockwave, who actually did not account for this. It was pretty much an ability he did not see coming, and Grimlock's Rage Boost just allowed him to just, you know, get the upper hand on Shockwave. He also has a small healing factor, being able to heal organs, you know, that were ripped out by Shockwave, even heal his optics once he got the DNA. So, yeah, I think it's safe to say that, Grimlock is pretty powerful. He also has an Ion Sword and Ion Shield. His Ion Sword, like it sounds, is able to cut ion particles, the smallest particles known to man. And his Ion Shield is capable of, well, you know, holding up to the same attacks as he is. He's also a very skilled combatant, spending time in the pits of Kaon. Probably on the same skill level as Megatron in terms of gladiatorial combat, maybe slightly lower. But needless to say, at the end of the day, Grimlock is definitely one of the strongest beings in comics. If you guys have watched my previous videos before I had to, you know, delete and re-edit them, you know, I actually put Grimlock on the same tier as characters like Hulk, Superman, and Godzilla, respectively. So, yeah, Grimlock is incredibly powerful and is incredibly strong and incredibly durable, and I would have to say he is definitely beyond the strength of a Prime from what he's done. So, let me know what you guys think down below. Please comment, like, and subscribe, and share with your friends. This will actually still, you know, lead into Grimlock versus the Hulk, and I hope you guys stick around for that.